Afternoon, everyone. Dr. Greg Murphy, 3rd Congressional District in Eastern North Carolina. It's Monday, March 16th, and I wanted to bring you just today's update about the coronavirus. Today, I'd like to talk about things we do know about the coronavirus. There have been a lot of myths that have been spread on the internet, so let's talk about what we do know. COVID-19, the coronavirus, can be transmitted in hot and humid areas. So traveling south does not mean that there are any parts of this country that we're not going to be able to go to where we are not susceptible to getting infected with the virus. Number two, cold. Cold does not kill the virus itself. So freezing things does not kill the virus. We have to be mindful of that. Sunlight. I'm out here in the beautiful Eastern North Carolina sunlight today. Sunlight, the UV light, can actually kill the virus. You have to be careful. You don't want to go out and get sunburned, but it's also a good thing with social distancing that we're outside rather than all gathered together in a group. There have been a lot of myths on the internet, so let's knock those away. Gargling with hot water and vinegar does not kill the virus. All it's going to give you is a bad taste in your mouth. Thermal scanners can help detect those who have temperatures that are higher than normal, and those individuals may be sick. Thermal scanners won't be able to detect anyone who is actually carrying the virus and infected with it, so that's where we're using those. The flu vaccine, number six. Flu vaccine is very important that we would have gotten this year, but it does not protect against the coronavirus. Here's another one on the internet. Rinsing your nose with saline, that does not protect you. All it's gonna do is give you a good case of the sinusitis. We don't need that. One thing that's so important, and I think hopefully people understand this right now, the older individuals are the ones who are most at risk. They need to be isolated. They need to stay at home. But what we also don't need is we don't need grandchildren going and visiting their grandparents because they could be carrying the virus home to them. So let's be smart about this for a little while. We can text, we can Skype, we can do FaceTime, all those things. And let me flip this over here real quick. And we're about finishing up. Number nine, the vaccine. There is no specific vaccine available today that will protect you against the coronavirus. It's probably going to be a year. There are no specific treatments for the coronavirus. In some certain viral situations, we can give certain medicine. In this one, we can't. We have to treat you like you have a bad case of the flu and support you as we would do otherwise. Number 10, and this is where it's so important, prevention is the key here. Keeping hands washed, keeping them sterilized with alcohol-based cleansers is really important. If you have to cough or sneeze, do it into a tissue or do it into your elbow. Don't handshake. I think everybody gets it by now, but it's really so hard to break. That's what we've been taught since we were young. Don't, if you can, try to avoid touching countertops, counting surfaces, doorknobs, elevator buttons that other individuals touch. You know, the good old elbow comes out very handy these days. And what we're finding out now, work from your home if at all possible. This is where it's important that people stay away from one another. You know, a lot of places here at the hospital, we're not going to be able to do that. But if at all possible, work from home from your computer. And that's what's really going to keep people away from one another. And finally, and really most importantly, is we will get through this. We as a nation are a nation of individuals. We care for each other. We care for our families and our community. We will get through this. So let's be smart. Our actions will affect the health and well-being of other people. So please, be smart. And God bless. I'll bring you another update soon.